what the heck is NoFastMem? This is Epic's Rogue, a remake of the originator of the roguelike genre, released in 1986. It's running on my Amiga 1200, which has 2 MB of chip RAM and 128 MB of fast RAM. A pretty beastie classic Amiga. Now I'll just enter my name in and... is the dungeon supposed to be this dark? I know older games can be hard to play, but... One thing that makes Amiga computers Amigas are their custom chips. Most older computers have custom chips to handle audio, video, and inputs and outputs, and the Amigas were some of the most powerful ones around. The Amiga was designed at a time when RAM was very expensive. The original Amiga 1000, released in 1985, came with only 256 KB of RAM. The Amiga's custom chips, Agnes, Denise, and Paula, have full access to that 256 KB. They handle blitter operations, copper lists, screen rendering, sprites, and audio, floppy, and some human input device handling. These chips have direct access to this RAM, making the coordination between all of their various functions fast and fluid. The Amiga's CPU, the Motorola 68000, works with Agnes to reserve RAM for the custom chips. Since the memory Agnes manages is the only memory the custom chips can directly access, it's called chip RAM. An expansion door on the front of the Amiga 1000 lets you expand chip RAM to 512 KB, which makes it possible to actually play Rogue. The 68000 can also get RAM expansions just for itself. This RAM is different from chip RAM. Since it doesn't have to go through Agnes's slower memory management, it's called fast RAM. There's a third type of Amiga RAM. My Amiga 500 had a memory expansion that provided 512 KB of slow RAM. It's slow since Agnes manages access to it, but the custom chips can't use it, so it's treated like fast RAM. All programs need memory to maintain state. In simple systems like the NES or Commodore 64, there's designated spots where you're allowed to put data. On these single process systems, your code is the only code running, so you can do whatever you want. Not so with the Amiga. The Amiga is a multi-process system, which means more than one program can run at one time. You can't guarantee memory you write to won't be immediately overwritten by something else. We need some way to manage memory usage and allocation. AmigaOS provides a multitasking friendly way of allocating memory via a library function called allocmem. Its behavior is simple. Request a chunk of memory of a particular size, and allocmem will try and reserve one for you. If it can, it returns the start address of the memory chunk. If it can't find one big enough, it returns zero. Imagine you want to reserve space at a restaurant for your family. You call ahead and place a reservation for 30, and the restaurant lets you know your reservation is successful and where you'll be sitting. When you get there, the restaurant's indoor service is top-notch. They arrange your seating, they bring you delicious food, they put on movies. Later, the restaurant adds a picnic area, where you bring your own blanket, food, and entertainment. The next time you call the restaurant, you ask for space for 30 again, and the restaurant gives you your seating location, but neither you nor them specified whether you wanted indoor or outdoor seating. You were expecting indoor seating, but the restaurant gave you outdoor since there's more space outside. Sadly, you brought no food or frisbees, so you're not going to have a great time. This is how allocmem works. Along with requesting how much memory you want, you request your preferences for where you want the RAM to come from. You can specify chip RAM or fast RAM, or you can let allocmem decide for you. Between 1985 and 1986, when Rogue was written, letting allocmem decide where the RAM came from for drawing dungeon tiles was pretty safe. On an Amiga 1000 with the chip RAM expansion, the target system for Rogue at the time, you'll always get chip RAM. Since Rogue has chip RAM, Agnes can use its blitter to copy the graphics data around for Denise to render on the screen. Soon, fast RAM started becoming more common in Amigas. If you don't specify what you want, allocmem will deliver fast RAM first, since chip RAM is precious. Now Agnes can't use its blitter to copy Rogue's dungeon graphics, since the graphics aren't in chip RAM, and whoops, you have a dark dungeon. This is a great example of it works on my computer, as well as needing clear documentation. Of course, Rogue worked everywhere at first. Realistically, there was only chip RAM and Amigas at the time. The behavior of allocmem when no preference is given is buried in parameter documentation, making it easy to miss. Making your request be the equivalent of shrug means that allocmem will try all the memory spaces, and in later developer documentation, that try order is stated right up front, rather than being buried in a parameter's documentation. Here's a code example. I allocate 2 RAM blocks, A and B, using allocmem. I don't specify where I want the RAM to come from. I stick a string in the A block, then I ask Agnes to use its blitter to copy the contents of the A block to the B block. The blitter will copy anything, so long as the source and destination are in chip RAM. This is also the only place in the code documentation I could find where giving fast RAM pointers to the custom chips could result in destruction of the contents of chip memory. Fun! Finally, I print out the contents of the B block. On my Amiga 1200, running this with fast RAM enabled means nothing gets copied from A to B, since AlocMem picks fast RAM first. Then I run NoFastMem, which disables fast RAM completely. Rewriting my program now with only chip RAM enabled makes the blitter operation succeed, and my string gets copied. So yeah, that's NoFastMem, one of the several programs with rabbit-themed icons that appeared in AmigaOS over the years. Now, if you'll excuse me, I have a randomly generated, brightly colored dungeon to crawl.